Good morning, everyone.
Hi.
I hope everyone's doing well today. It is, oh my goodness, I think it's probably only about 7 o'clock in the morning here in Ontario, Canada, and it's so hot already. I'm up on the fourth floor, and of course, the heat up here is so much hotter than downstairs. And anyway, it is what it is. Like I've said before, it's Ontario. You never know what you're gonna get. So today, I'm doing a funnel pour. I've had this in the back of my mind for quite a while. I did a few back at the beginning of my channel. I have one of my favorite ones I'm gonna link up above. And it was my very first piece to sell. So I will show you that. It's called Open Copper Mine. It's like probably within my first 10 videos. And I did another one that ended up looking like a dragon. So actually I might just link that one up above too. So yeah, I've had this in my mind, and I'm a registered nurse at our local hospital, and on my breaks, I watch all of my paint pouring friends on their YouTube channels. And I love Mark J. Ratcliffe Art. He's amazing. He is the moderator of our Facebook group for Molly Rinska and Olga's painting course, and like, good for you, Mark, for being the moderator of a Facebook group with quite a few women. It's like 99% women, I would say, and he is doing a fabulous job. So I will link his channel up above. And I'm gonna get going here. I have one more shout out I wanna do, so stay tuned for that one because she's a special friend. And hopefully someday her and I get to meet, because I just feel like layer in a pattern. I like random. I am an intuitive painter. I just sort of go by, what color should I add next? What color should I add next? Okay, are we ready here? All right. It's good to just give it a couple of seconds in between to let the paint run down the side of the funnel. Okay, so I have decided to do a little bit of extra to this one. I'm not gonna use any of the garnet, but I do have my berry, my ultramarine blue, my Montmartre magenta, and my copper gold mix. I just got this really cool kitchen strainer. It's like perfect. So, we're gonna play. Thank you. Okay, guys, so that's how you fix a painting you don't like. And just keep at it. I am learning that it is just paint. And you know what? This turned out amazing. I love the copper gold with the blue and the pink. They make beautiful colors, and that's exactly what happened. So, yay! Ow! Oh, and I just hit the end of my... Oh, I just hit the end of my blowtorch with my bare arm. Yeah, that hurt. So don't do that. That's my tutorial for today. Don't touch the end of your blowtorch after you've been using it. I'm okay. I didn't burn myself, I don't think, anyway. Maybe a little bit, but it's all good. It's all good. All right, I will bring you in for a close-up. So after all that work, I realized I never did do a close-up of the wet results. I took pictures, but I did not do a close-up. So I'm going to give you the dried results and a close-up at the same time. Okay, so here's the dried results. It looks really good. Beautiful purples from that ultramarine blue and the magenta. The copper gold just gives it some great extra color. I love this piece a lot. It looks so good. The shine of that gold is just so pretty. Amazing lacing. I love the Amsterdam paints. They're so great for swiping. So let me know what you thought of this piece. A little bit crazy. How many techniques can you do on one canvas in an hour? I think I worked at it a little longer than an hour, but it ended up turning out. So don't ever give up. It's just paint. I almost scraped it, but decided to just keep going, and it all turned out. So thanks everybody for watching this video. Part two of how to fix a piece that you don't like. Have a great day, everyone.